Hey y'all, hi, and welcome to the total disaster that is my vanity. It's been like this since we moved into this house. It's basically been increasing in messiness, and it's finally time, for me to organize all of my makeup and skincare, decide where it's all gonna go, probably declutter it, maybe kind of intensely along the way. I don't really have aspirations of decluttering a lot, but I have been feeling like I brought too much makeup with me when I moved to this new house. And I'm probably ready to let go of some stuff as I'm organizing it and putting it away. As part of this video, I'm also going to make a few changes to the bedroom at large. We finally have all of the furniture that we need in here. We have all of the pieces, and not everything is quite yet put into place. I hope by the end of this video it will be. If this is your first time to my channel, then welcome. I'm so glad you're here. My name is Hannah. I really love makeup and beauty, and I do review that kind of stuff on my channel. I also really like fashion and design, but I don't like the feeling of being overwhelmed with way too much stuff, and I don't like having more stuff than I can keep organized or kind of like keep in my mind palace. So I try not to buy too much. I try to be strategic about what I keep. And in this video, I'm going to be taking you through the process of being strategic about how I organize my stuff, trying to figure out ways to keep it put away so that it's accessible to me, but I don't feel like I'm overwhelmed by it. If you enjoy this, I hope you'll subscribe to my channel. And now, let's go ahead and get into the meat of the video. So before I start dealing with all of this business, I'm going to give you a quick like before tour of the entire room because I want you to be as satisfied as I'm going to be when you see the after at the end of the video. Probably of all of the rooms of the house, this is the one for which we needed to acquire the most pieces of furniture. We didn't have a bed frame. We didn't have any kind of closet organization system. We didn't have a dresser. I didn't bring my old broken vanity with me from LA. Everywhere else in the house, we have most of what we need and we're kind of just cobbling it together, but we had to make a massive effort to get the pieces in place in this room. The first thing that we did was to install this like closet system on one wall of the room. I'll show it to you now. We got it at Ikea. We installed it ourselves. It was a little bit difficult to get it installed really well. Joe and I are both pretty handy and he's really meticulous about measuring and doing everything properly, so we managed to do it, but it was harder than we thought it was going to be. That's the caveat. Other than that, it's fantastic. We absolutely love it. The bed frame was a very exciting and successful purchase. We brought our mattress with us from LA, but we didn't bring our extremely old and again, basically disintegrating bed frame that we had had for years. It was really cheap too, and this time around, I was determined for the first time in my life, basically, to buy a super sturdy, beautiful, well-made bed frame. And this is something that we're hoping will last for us forever. Like we're trying to buy our forever bed frame, but we didn't want to spend too much money on it. So we were specifically looking for a platform bed frame in a warm, versatile wood color that was extremely sturdy, visually minimal, relatively low to the ground, and we needed it to be available for delivery, which is like a huge thing right now. A lot of furniture companies, the furniture that they're selling, it's not available until like months from now. And we were like, no, we need it like within a couple of weeks. And we were hoping not to go over $500. So I scoured the internet and I found this one article and it blew us out of the water. It was delivered in a short amount of time. We put it together ourselves in about an hour. It's really solid. And I love the way that it looks. I love the kind of floating effect. Like you can't see the legs from the side. They're under there, they're holding it up, but to look at it, you would think that it's like floating off of the floor, and I just think it's absolutely beautiful. So very pleased with that. The side tables, the bedside tables we've had for a long time, they're from Ikea. Choosing something to use as a vanity table was also kind of a journey. Vanity tables, like dedicated vanity tables, are really expensive. And I was not out here looking to spend like $1,000 on some kind of elaborate vanity with a whole bunch of drawers and a glamorous glass top. I really wanted something that was long, that gave me kind of a pretty generous surface area on which to work. And it needed to be shallow, like not more than 15 inches deep, because I didn't want it to jut out too far into the room. And there are a lot of vanity tables that fit that description, but I couldn't find any that I thought looked beautiful, that looked like they would be sturdy, and that weren't wildly expensive. So searching with those proportions in mind eventually brought me to console tables, like the kinds of tables that are designed to be a landing station for your mail and trash and keys and stuff next to the door in an entryway. Console tables are also designed to be long and thin and shallow, and some of them have deep drawers, which is one of the things that I wanted for a vanity table. So I bought this one from Target. It's a console table. It's not marketed as a vanity. I believe it was on sale when we bought it, and I think it was under $300, which, you know, is a bit of an investment. It's a piece of furniture that we bought, but it's nowhere near the investment that it would have been to purchase like a dedicated vanity table. And I'm very, very pleased with the design. It's also very solid, was easy to put together, and it has these nice drawers that open and close easily. This straw bench that I'm sitting on is one that we've had for ages as well. For a while, I was looking for something a little bit more glamorous and comfortable, and then I realized, and I was using this one like as a stopgap. I was like, I'll just use that one until I find a really special one. Then I realized that it looks perfect in here. It's perfectly comfortable. I don't need some sort of velvet padded storage bench. I'm just gonna stick with this one. And the very last piece of furniture that's tying the whole room together is this beauty right here. Here's the story on this. After the bed frame arrived and we put it together, I was so impressed that I actually reached out to Article. I emailed them to see if they have any kind of influencer relations program or like an affiliate program. And they don't have an affiliate program, but they were excited that we liked the bed so much. And they asked if we wanted another piece of furniture. They were like, can we send you another piece of furniture? We would be happy to do that if you would review it in a video. And Joe and I had already been eyeing this dresser. We've never owned a dresser, and we really needed like a big solid one with deep drawers. We hadn't bought it yet because we were just going one piece at a time with furnishing the house because furniture is so expensive, but we'd basically already picked it out. So we jumped at the chance. They sent it to us. And again, this video isn't sponsored by Article or anything. They just asked me to review it in a video. And the review is that it's amazing. Just like the bed frame, beautiful, solid, quick delivery, easy to assemble. I'm a huge fan of these soft closed drawers. That was like my dream. When we were looking for dressers, I was like, I don't care as long as it has the soft closed drawers. I think that if I had not reached out to Article and we had just waited a month or two and then bought the dresser ourselves, I would be just as happy with it. And overall, my experience with Article has been great. The delivery is really easy to schedule, it's personalized, and one of the things I've really appreciated is that the delivery people are always really cheerful. They're efficient, they're only here for about 2 seconds, they drop off the stuff and get the job done, and they were on time both times, but they didn't bring any stress vibes with them. They were really friendly and smiley, and I like that. It makes a big difference to me. So we have all the furniture. We love all the furniture, but I feel like it's not being shown off to its best effect yet because of this mess, right? There isn't a place for everything and everything in its place, either in or on the vanity or in or on the dresser. And I have a dream of this corner of the room looking very bright and clean and calm, having things put away and having it just be a space that's easy to move around and function in, because we're making heavy use of this corner of the room, both of us. Joe is basically using the top of the dresser as his vanity. He stands here and does his like skincare and hair care and stuff. So I need to get it together. The things that I need to do are to organize and declutter the makeup, hang the mirrors, because both of these mirrors can be hung, mounted on the wall instead of just sitting on top of their surfaces. And I'm really hoping that we can accomplish that today. I think that's going to make a huge difference. I want to hang a little bit more art. I feel like there's room for a piece of art at least right here on this wall, if not not in a couple of other places over here. This room also needs a thorough vacuuming and a bit of a tidy. In the footage of the before, you might have seen that there's like some random stuff sitting around, and I need to deal with that today too. So here's what I'm dealing with in terms of storage. I have these three drawers and they're pretty deep. So far, I have just been like throwing things into them. Like it's really, really disorganized. There are a bunch of brushes in here and some lip products. In this drawer, I've been kind of keeping like my everyday makeup, the makeup that I reach for a lot. I mean, I've been sort of trying to do that. As you can see, pretty much everything's just everywhere. And then it's been lip products and cheek products in this drawer. That was just my initial stopgap organization system. I might not end up deciding to keep things there. I haven't made any decisions. I'm going to be doing that today. So I've got those three drawers, and I also have this. This is basically like a makeup artist's case. The top part opens like this, and the pieces lift off of each other. So I have a bunch of stuff stored in this, and the reason that I have this thing is that my YouTube filming studio is two floors down in this house, right? So this is the top floor, and the studio is down in the basement. Whenever I film, I have to take makeup down there, and that's usually what I use this for. So this has in it kind of my most used makeup, the stuff I always use when I'm filming, but it's also sort of a rotating complement of things that I'm using to film. And then I've been using the other compartments in this makeup case, the bottom compartment, which is really big and deep, and the other, I guess, three that stack on top of each other for other makeup. Makeup that I'm maybe not using every day or not as likely to use every day. I think that I want more everyday use makeup to be in the drawers to be easily accessible. I'm less frequently used makeup to be in the bottom parts of the makeup case, but I think I'm probably going to figure out some of those things as I go along. Skincare is a little bit more difficult. I want to store some of my skincare on top of the vanity, and I want to store some of my skincare in a caddy or two, like a little box with a handle on top, actually inside of the dresser drawers, because I don't want too much stuff out all the time. I would like things to be able to be put away to keep the sense of clarity and calm in the space. And I've ordered some little caddies, and I think they're going to be perfect, and the drawers are so deep that they will fit into them with clearance. I've actually already measured, but they're not getting here till tomorrow. So I'm going to do my best with maybe some little shallow boxes instead of caddies to organize my skincare, sort out which skincare is going to sit on top of the vanity and be visible all the time, and which skincare is going to be stored away in these drawers. I think that what I need to do is to just set up a shot so that you'll be able to see me working, and then just like buckle down and power through the first part of this. I'm probably going to take everything out, kind of assess the situation, start going through, and if anything of interest comes up, I will stop and let you know what's going on. Okay. Here's what I've done so far. I made sense of the really mixed, messy chaos that was on the surface by separating the skincare from the makeup. We're like really starting at zero over here. Everything was just all mixed together. And I also separated the body care and hair care. So I put the body care and hair care aside, what was on the surface. I put it aside for the time being, put the skincare here on the bench with me, and I just put the makeup that was all mixed in here. I intend to use one of these pieces to hold PR products that I'm testing, and I haven't maybe made content with them yet, or I haven't decided if I'm gonna keep them or not. But there was some other stuff mixed in, so I kind of like cleared that out, and now that's what's happening in this piece of the makeup case. But I still haven't gone through the drawers, and I think that what I need to do now that I have space is to take the makeup out of the drawers and take makeup out of the top part of the case. because I've been carrying this up and down with me and using it to film and filmed a bunch of different kinds of videos with it. A bunch of different things have collected, different brushes. I mean, it's absolute chaos. It's not organized. I've been experiencing this thing when I sit down to get ready for the past, week or two. I just kind of don't quite know where most things are. And I'm sort of just grabbing whatever is closest to hand. But I'd like to have a system. I'd like to know where I'm storing all of my base products, like foundations and concealers, green color correctors, where I'm storing my brushes, even if they're stored permanently in here. I just need to make decisions about all of this. And I think that in order to sort it all out, I'm really gonna have to like go into my head space and do it. It's going to take some focus and thinking about the way that I function on a day-to-day basis with my own makeup and with the channel. That's what I'm gonna do next. I'm gonna open all the drawers, I'm gonna take out all the makeup, I'm gonna put skincare aside for the time being, and I'm going to come up with a system. And once I've kind of gotten there, I'll check in with you and I'll let you know what I've decided. I'm feeling a little bit overwhelmed by a couple of things, but I have made what I think is a crucial decision. I've decided that I want this to just be for transporting things downstairs for filming and not a place where I store my everyday makeup. I really want my everyday makeup that I'm always reaching for, that I always want to know where it is. I want it to have a place that it belongs that is in this drawer, and or maybe two of these drawers. But this middle drawer, I want to put like my most used foundation products, mascaras, the things that I'm reaching for on an everyday basis, whether I'm filming or not. And I want this to be like kind of like a handbag. So I'm going to try to do that, to like figure out a little capsule of makeup for this drawer. I think that will help me put away a lot of what is here on the surface now. The other thing that overwhelmed me is brushes. I just have too many makeup brushes for me. Like, I don't need this many, and I feel like only about half of them are the ones that I use a lot, the ones that I really, really love. I don't feel like I have the energy today to like definitively, decisively declutter my brushes to the point where I'm like getting rid of them. But I think that what I can do is to sort out the ones that I know that I use a lot from the ones that I'm not sure about, and I can put the ones that I'm not sure about away for a little while and then see how I feel without them. And then when I get ready to actually make decluttered decisions, I'll be better prepared. I've accomplished some things. I did indeed put it's all of my complexion products, I realize what I want here, because when I am just kind of putting myself together but I'm not actually doing a very elaborate makeup look, these are the products that I use the most. So even though I have like a selection of green color correctors and a selection of concealers, primers, and those kinds of things, that's what I want like front and center, because that's the stuff that I use. And also the brow products, which for me right now, it's just the Refi Brow Gel and the Glossier Brow Flick. It's like all that I have for brows. And my mascaras, because I'll often wear mascara even if I'm not wearing much else on my face. So all of that's here in the center. And at the end, I'll give you like a closer up tour so you'll be able to see everything more closely. But for the time being, I'm just telling you that's what's here. I felt like I wasn't making good use of the space because I don't have that. It's not like the drawer is at capacity and I don't have that much space overall. So I also decided to include lip butters and lip balms, like nourishing lip products in this drawer, because I almost always put one of them onto my lips on a daily basis too. I have weeded out, and it was so easy to weed out these brushes. A lot of them are like really old, like brushes that I've had for a really long time, some of them since before my channel. And then some of them are brushes that brands sent to me that are perfectly nice. They're just not as nice as the rougher brushes for eye, which is what I really prefer for eyes. I don't want to have like backup brushes. So I actually think it's going to be easier than I thought that it would be to go ahead and get rid of these brushes. But for now, I'm keeping them in this box, kind of in a state of like pre-declutter. Thank you. Okay, hi. There have been some moments where I wasn't sure if I would see the light. They feel like a lot of progress has been made. I'll tell you what's going on right now, and then I'll tell you what's going to happen next. So I put all of my lip products all together into one drawer, which I'm really enjoying. I did manage to declutter some, mostly glosses. I put them in here with the brushes. Right now, I am creating a kind of pre-declutter box. I feel like it's working well for me to put things in this box that I'm like pretty sure that I'm ready to declutter. And then I'll come back like maybe sometime next week or maybe even just in the next couple of days and reassess. So I weeded out 10 or 12 lip products and that's feeling really great. This drawer we already talked about. And then in this drawer, I have my cheek products like blushes and stuff and hair ties and hairbands and bobby pins. I actually couldn't find room in these three drawers for this red box of like in-use complexion brushes that aren't directly on top of the table. I think that I'm probably going to put them in one of the storage caddies that goes into one of the drawers of the dresser, which is right behind me and within reach. And skincare is also going to be distributed between a little like riser that I got that again is coming tomorrow. That's going to be on top of the surface and a caddy or two in the drawers in the dresser. So a lot of decisions have been made about like what's going to go in here, what's going to go on here, and where everything is going to be. But as you may have noticed, conspicuously absent from this arrangement is eyeshadow. All kinds of eye makeup except for mascara. I really want to move into a total shop my stash model for eyeshadow. I feel like it's going to work really well for me to have my eyeshadow sort of in semi-storage and to choose on a weekly basis which eyeshadow I want to have on the vanity. I don't need all of my eyeshadow palettes like in the drawers or on top of the vanity. When I had them like that in the house before, I was mostly just ignoring them and then every once in a while I would go through them and pick one and I would use that one for like a week or two. So they don't need to be, again, taking up physical space, taking up visual space. And because I have this caddy with all of the compartments for storage for makeup, that is like semi-storage, right? I have to do a little work to access what's in them, but they're gonna be right here next to the vanity because I'm gonna keep this makeup case right here. Most of my eyeshadow palettes and glitters and stuff are already in this. And I am now going to just go through and make sure that everything's exactly where I want it to be. Hey y'all. Okay, so I feel like a lot of progress has been made. Not everything is put away, but I've made a lot of decisions about where things are going to go, how my system is going to work with storing things, using things, etc. So I'm really feeling like the brunt of the work, the hard work, has pretty much been done. The makeup is actually all put away. So the things that I use the most in these drawers, and then the eyeshadows and other kinds of eye makeup that I'm just going to want to kind of dip into once in a while and maybe rotate onto the vanity. That's all in here. I picked a couple of palettes to live on top of the vanity and a couple of eyeliners to live in this drawer just so they'll be right there when I want them. And that's definitely going to be enough for me in the day to day. And I'm really looking forward to moving into like a rotating sort of shop my stash eyeshadow model. This is the box of pre-declutter brushes and makeup. This is a box of my skincare and I'm going to have to decide what's going to live on the vanity and what's gonna live in one of these drawers. So that's one of the things I'm gonna do next. These brushes are going to go in one of those drawers. And then I have some like body care products and hair care products that were taking up a lot of space, making things very chaotic in here. And those are products that I don't use every day and I don't need to store them out on my vanity or in the vanity drawers. Some of them will probably go into a drawer of the dresser, and some of them will probably go into a little tray that I have in the linen closet next to the bathroom. So now that things are all sorted into their separate baskets, I'm feeling like I want to do some cleaning. I'd like to vacuum in here, really get all of the little things that are in places where they don't belong, get them put away, and then make final decisions about where all the skincare, hair care, and body care is going to go. But I think that that means that it's time to hang the mirrors, because I know that it's probably going to make a little bit of a mess when we do it. We're going to have to drill into the wall, and I don't want to vacuum now and then create that mess and then have to vacuum again. Going to do it for today, and I'm feeling incredibly gratified by the results of this. I knew that I wanted it to be clear. I knew that I wanted to get the mirrors up on the walls, get some art up on the wall, but I think that I didn't anticipate how much it would transform the sense of being in the room. Even though this is all brand new and we just got it finished, just standing here and looking around and feeling the vibe, this feels like a lived-in space, whereas before, like an inhabited space, you know? Before, it really did feel like we were kind of camping out on this side of the room. So I'm just really excited that I made the time and actually followed through with every single aspect of the project. Little touches that have particularly pleased me. One, we took the time to do some cable management while we had the dresser and the vanity pulled off of the walls. We tacked the cables against the walls behind the furniture and along the edges of the molding so that they're not sort of waving around everywhere. And it was a lot easier than I thought that it would be and a lot more effective than I thought that it would be. It's much easier to kind of get cables tacked down than you think. And the impact, it's just, even though you can still see a cable against the wall here and there, it's dramatically different from having the cables just strewn all over the floor. Also, when I was downstairs choosing art for this space, I chose to bring this vase up here. I got this vase for 50 cents at a Goodwill years ago, back when I lived in Portland, Oregon, and I've just been carrying it around from city to city ever since. I like the idea. I don't think I've ever done this before, but I like the idea of having a vase on the vanity because it kind of implies that there might occasionally or maybe even regularly be flowers on the vanity. So I could see this also going on the top of the dresser as a feature, as some art that's here in the space. And I can also see it living on the vanity or moving back and forth between these two spots. I feel like putting the vase there, hanging this art, putting a couple of pieces of makeup and perfume here, it really did a lot to tie the whole thing together. I love it. I'm so happy with the outcome. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I should tell you before I sign off. The vacuum I wanted to tell you about, I'm sure you'll see footage of me vacuuming. That is actually a new and I think newly released vacuum from Samsung. They got in touch and they were like, "Do you ever vacuum on camera?" And I was like, "Yes, especially now because of doing content like this." And then they sent that vacuum. It's really, really nice. I mean, it's a very, very fancy, futuristic feeling vacuum. And Joe and I both love using it. We were like both really into vacuuming. The house has never been so clean. I think that that's it. If there's anything else that I forgot to communicate, I'll try to make sure that we communicate it visually with the footage of the finished space. But I feel like this is a situation where the picture is going to be worth more than words. And I'm excited to take that footage, which is what I'm going to do right now, and really like bring you into the feel of the space and kind of show you how it has all come together. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed this one. I will link the last like home organization vlog that I made because I feel like if you enjoyed this video, you will probably enjoy that one, even though it doesn't have as much makeup specific content. It's more of just a tasks around the house video. I recommend watching it if you haven't yet seen it. I also hope you'll subscribe before you go if you're not subscribed. But whatever you choose to do, don't forget to take extra good care of yourself today so that you can be the most effective version of yourself as you do your work in the world.